With dining in allowed again and people returning to hawker centers, are they cleaning up after themselves? As part of ongoing efforts to maintain high standards of public hygiene and cleanliness amid the pandemic, since June 1st, it's mandatory for patrons to return their trays and clear their table litter. But to help them adjust, no enforcement action will be taken until August 31st.
You know, this practice of clearing your tables after yourselves, you know, after eating at our public dining places, not only would show consideration to other diners, but would also provide our cleaners as well as ultimately ourselves with a cleaner and safer environment. And returning your used crockery and tray would also help to reduce the workload of the cleaners so that they can focus on cleaning and sanitizing the tables, as well as facilitate the faster turnover of tables during peak meal times. And I think this is indeed very useful at a time when we are actually limiting the number of diners per table. I think this will strengthen our resilience against COVID-19 and future public health threats. And indeed, I actually hope that this habit of clearing your tables after yourselves at public dining places will become a habit that we will all be proud of.
Here at Northbridge Road Food Centre, it appears most people have complied with the rules. We observe them putting their used bowls and cutlery back onto trays and bringing them to the tray return stations. If they forget, banners and little stands on the tables have been set up with helpful reminders.
昨天就三个了，十个只有三个来还，我很高兴，我不怕没有工作，我老板不要请他讲，你们做你们的，我们还会照请你们，他讲，你们不用担心。早上我们也是遇到，叫他们收他们不收的，他说他是来吃东西的，他没有负责，他说他不管，我们是做这行工作，我们负责，不管他的事。 你罚款他就知道，原来不可以开玩笑，政府讲到做到，叫我们吃重，我们不收，不收又不听讲，我们罚款。
Generally, they will say the cleaning job is not it's not on them lah. Basically, they want the cleaners to do the cleaning job. But our officers will actually try to explain to them that the cleaners have their own duty at the tray return rack. So once everyone play their part, the workflow will work smoothly, and then everything flow accordingly during peak period. The tray and crockery will be turned over very fast lah. Okay, so normally the officers will approach them and greet them and remind them that after you finish your meal, please return the dirty tray and crockery. And if they leave without clearing their own tray and crockery, the officers will approach them as well to remind them. Okay, so come September, we will take advice first. It's only when they fail to listen to our advisory, then we will proceed to take enforcement action. We will request for their particulars and then take back end to process. So we will send them letters.
First time offenders will be given a written warning. Second time offenders will face a $300 composition fine, and subsequent offences may lead to court fines, which can go up to $2,000 for the first conviction.
会会会，你如果吃完了就弄干净，放回去，好了，就证据放来放去好了。
I think we gotta start somewhere. So sooner or later, I think eventually we are going to expect that we have to take care of our own plates anyway. Yeah, it's definitely going to be painful at the beginning. So I don't see another way about it.
有时候我们老人走路不方便，老人家你看很多这边的人都是过，什么要到100岁的80、70、80、90走路都自己都要跌倒了，你还叫人家自己蹬啊推，那有可能的事嘛？可以鼓励人家做，不可以强制。
Whether or not the public is happy about this, the penalties for offences will kick in from September 1st. The Singapore Food Agency will work with the National Environment Agency to work out enforcement progressively at coffee shops and food courts in the fourth quarter of this year. Kim Lee Jiao for The Straits Times.